starting life for today. Thank you very much. Can I call upon President Anita Bansari to address the club?
Thank you very much for being with us here today. We are thrilled to have you. I'm certain that with your presence today, we can reach
here. Please accept our heartiest welcome.
Filmmaker, choreographer, celebrated television personality, wife and mother, Farah Khan. 26 years ago, it wasn't easy to break into Bollywood as choreographer, but Farah Khan, with over 100 blockbuster songs, managed to become the most sought after in her profession after debuting with Joke, Jeeta Hi Sikandar in 1992. She recently choreographed Tarife from Veeradi Wedding and Zinka from Darak. Her directorial debut, Mehbuna, in 2004 was a monstrous success. She raised the bar by turning on films like Om Shanti Om, Teesma Khan and Happy New Year, and went on to become the most commercially successful female filmmaker of all time. A huge feat. She managed this while continuing to be a super mom to her triplets and judging reality shows with her signature sense of humor. I present to you Ms. Farah Khan. Can I request President Anita Bansari to give a token of appreciation to Ms. Farah Khan? Welcoming our author, Sharmila Rieberious. And our moderator for today, Ms. Amisha Bhai. Welcome to the club. Thank you so much. And now I hand over the mic, Ms. Amisha Bhai, to start with the event. Thank you so much.
Mumbai is the city of my birth, my schooling, my college, and it's home. So it's really lovely to be here. I'm going to ask Farah, of course, to launch the book. Farah, thank you so much for encouraging me to write the book, for giving me comments all through the way where I was writing the book, for writing.
अरे स्टील
फ्लैश का
फ्लैश का निकालना भाई
थैंक यू फारा फॉर राइटिंग द फॉरवर्ड एंड फॉर बीइंग हियर टुडे देयर इज नो ग्रेटर गिफ्ट टू आवर 45 ईयर ओल्ड फ्रेंडशिप एंड व्हाट फारा I never got where I was in when I was younger, but I think it's good that we encourage our children to eat healthy. So thank you for writing this. Sharmila, it took a good 5 years or more to get her to do this. She has three big boys, yeah, take up all her time. So let's get on with the Q&A now before your... I want to thank Anisha for being here to moderate. I want to specially mention my... Anisha, thank you for being here. I want to mention my mom. My mom, Ada Rivero, just mommy, please stand up. She is beautiful and elegant at 87 years old. She's an amazing person. She starts her day with yoga. She spends it in social service with the poor and ends it with church. And she's blessed and I am to be her daughter. So thank you for being my inspiration. In fact, my friends all over, including Farah, crave her cooking, not mine. So that's, thank you. I self-published this book because I wanted a book that was not only useful, but I wanted a beautiful looking book that would inspire people to cook healthy. And so thank you, Rotary Club of Mumbai Elegant, for hosting this launch. It's really, really sweet of you. And so do accept a token of my gratitude to Anita Pansari. Sharmila has really spent a lot of time putting this event together, so I'm really grateful to her. Sarita Dalmia. I know you're all waiting for this discussion to start, so with that said, let's start, Anisha.
Aliya mein, Aliya Bhatt.
Hello, yes.
Hi.
Hello, Anisha. So I have to say, I have a Sharmila blog, but we are connected goals from a larger extended time. Farah, of course, I've known for years. I've harassed her.
Harassed and hounded me many a time. This is a payback. She has to come here and do this for free now.
I don't know exactly. I think it has something to do with the words yakni and pulao. But it struck me as interesting that the journey of the two of you actually began with different boxes and it seems to be culminating once again in different boxes. So over 45 years?
Yeah, so we've been friends since third standard. Don't do the math, I'm very old. And literally Sharmila's tiffin was my favorite part of school, you know, of coming to school, because my tiffin normally didn't have anything in it. And Sharmila's mother used to cook the most amazing things. I don't know whether I should say I was introduced to ham and sausages very early, not knowing I wasn't supposed to eat them. So that's how we have been friends, and we have stayed friends over her going off to America and living abroad, and then us getting married, and we have 6 kids between us now. And the friendship continues, and I've been telling her to write this book for really long. I'm just happy she finally got down to doing it.
I actually, and for, you know, I think everyone else would be curious, take us back to the third standard, each of you. Like, what were you like? Who was the troublemaker? Who was the...
She became head girl, so clearly she was not the troublemaker. No, but there was always a competition because I used to both come first. So there was always a competitive...
Farah was definitely smart, okay? She always came first for years and years.
Troublemaker also, or no?
She was fun. Farah was always fun. And one of my memories actually, which I probably never shared before, is Farah ended up as a choreographer. and we danced together with our PT teacher, Miss Motiwala, the tango. We were taught to dance the tango.
We were in an all-girls school, so that is why she had to be the boy and I had to be the girl. Nothing fishy otherwise.
Dancing career started in school.
Mine was with food also, but mine was the eating part of it. For every holiday or after school, I would be at a house where my mom would feed me, and those were like my best memories of school. So you know, I'm just glad that I can do this now. So it's a payment for Auntie Ada's cooking actually.
You know, when you grow up in a family where there's always good food, you just end up wanting to eat good food always. And I think that's the challenge for all of us who like to eat and we're always struggling.
How many of us like to eat? You are not putting a hand up. You are not a foodie, please get out. Then actually this book is good for you.
Healthy food does not have to be not tasty, okay? The point of my point is that
it's not tasty, but healthy.
So again, tell us now a little bit about, again, the point of view. You call it everyday love, right? So explain what everyday love is.
See, the name was just so natural to me because when I just thought about what I was doing for my kids and what mothers and parents and people just do on a daily basis, which were probably not, people don't thank you for, kind of, is cooking for our families and planning meals and, you know, and that is really everyday love. You know, you don't have to tell your kids you love you or your husband you love you, but the fact that you're feeding them. And to me, if you really start to make conscious decisions of what you feed your kid, that is really truly love. So I'm saying, you know, everyday love is healthy cooking now. Try to change the meaning a bit. And I fed my kids lots of junk food, you know, and I did it lovingly and indulgently. You don't think about what you feed my kids. My kids would like want gummy bears, I would bring gummy bears back and Oreo cookies and whatever they wanted, you know, mango drinks which are full of sugar. And when I started to write this book and think about healthy eating and how I wanted my family to eat better, I realized how bad the junk food was. So to me, everyday love is just putting that extra effort of thinking about what you put into your food, into your plates and your family. So
is that everyday love for you too?
Everyday love for me is eating good food. No, of course, I think now, especially for all of us and the millennial moms, what we feed our kids, everything is become quite, people have become quite obsessive about it. You know, like, are we feeding our kids healthy? I think as mothers only, we become obsessed with our kids. What are they doing? What are they eating? What are the classes they go to? What are the play dates? So I think it's good to know that because I think I'm much older than all of y'all. So our parents were not so much into, we didn't know what was healthy food and unhealthy food. So we were just eating everything, which is why at least I grew up with wanting to diet, yo-yo diet, putting on weight and losing weight and trying to, you know. So it's better to give them the habit from childhood or as they're growing up to eat healthy, and that becomes a habit for life, which we all struggle with because that habit was never cultivated in us.
And through this book is how you discover the choice of avocado.
Okay.
But I just want to add out, I think that what we grew up with, all of us, was home cooking. You know, and my book is, the message is that you just go back to everyday cooking. Because whatever you buy from a store or, when we eat out or stuff, and all of that is fine. Everything, you know, eating out, eating cookies and cakes and all treats is fine. But, you know, that's once in a while. As I tell you, it's sometimes food and anytime food. But the going back to home cooking, I think, is what I'm really advocating. Because then you know what you're putting into your food, right? So.
And I know, I do. I mean, everyone is obsessed with their children and child obesity and, you know, like what kind of children are eating or drinking.
It's not only children actually. 2 weeks ago I was at a Women in Diabetes conference in Chennai and it was really horrifying actually for us as women getting to this age of the statistics. Indians apparently are already predisposed to diabetes. And so we really need to be
very sweet.
Sweet. So as women also, we really need to watch out what we're eating.
Have you approached any of her recipes?
Yeah, of course. I have Farah's famous roast chicken with lots of chili, garlic, lemon, honey, and it's delicious. Yeah, it's healthy also. It's a roast chicken. I do it in my oven. Yeah.
I'm calling you home. Yeah. Okay. The entire rotary is invited to my house.
I've always believed, you know, the reason, again, I've had such an affinity for food, and arguably for Farah as well, is that food brings, the great thing about food is the ability to bring people together. That there are these wonderful traditions, tastes that we inherit, you know, all of that. So can you take us to sort of again back to where it began for both of you?
I discovered like Goan food and Goan because I was, had definitely not eaten any such food.
What did you have at home?
Our house was proper like Indian khana, but like more towards Muslim food. My dadi used to cook, so everything had lot of oil in it. Very delicious. Lot of oil, lot of mutton, lot of even the dal was like that. Muslim dal, the chapatis were rotis were this big. Yeah, like that for some time. And then when I discovered Sharmila's home food, it was all like, you know, like prawn curries and sot patel. All things which I never heard of, but they were just absolutely delicious. Like potato chops with mince in it, and can't say now, but I just had roast beef when it was allowed.
This tradition is coming together. Have you found sort of coming forward in your Sharmila that you've made new friends through food?
Yes, so for me, my social life revolves around my food, my lunches and my dinners. I even did an entire food show called Farah Ki Dawat, because I was so, I was so with like-minded people who all enjoyed food. And I think if you enjoy food and you meet another foodie, it's like an instant friendship. I think you all know that. Like food and like shoes for you. So I think that kind of connection that comes from food, and even when now if I have, I'd rather like call people over to eat food. It's a passion of mine to feed people, and I've seen that in Sharmila's house, at her mother's place. Even when I go to Chennai to work, everything revolves around the food, you know, which is really great.
Which is
exactly
what
you mean. I mean, anywhere you go to a wedding and the food is not good, I want to bitch it out as soon as you come. Like anywhere you go, the food is one of the main things that you enjoy when you go out. Either you go for a movie or for a party or for a wedding or for a holiday, everything revolves around food. It's a great unifier also.
It is a great unifier. It is entirely true. It is entirely true. For you, Sharmila, again, friendships change. Today is actually, I would say, testament to food and friendship. And again, it's powerful.
Yeah. Yeah, so food wasn't good for so long. I would have thought so. Be friends with somebody else.
I think I'm blessed that my mother has lived so long, because Farah's food stills. Every time I'm in Bombay, she comes over for. She doesn't get the chance to come to Chennai that often. So food in Bombay is still at my mom's house, so that's the blessing.
Even before yesterday, I was
at Aunty's. She knows all my favorite stuff. But yeah, food, I think cooking for friends and family, and you know, making that effort whenever it's possible is a great thing. So I just love to. I always, was different in the sense that I made sure, like my kids' birthday parties, I made everything from scratch. It was a challenge, but you know, my kids wanted to have their birthday parties at Domino's Pizza or at Pizza Hut, but I insisted that we do home cooked. And I think in hindsight, they appreciate that. That was way before I wrote my book, and while I was not, you know, making more party kind of food. But so that's the whole thing about just being.
But there is also no strategy with these flavors. There was a young intern who came to the office who would bring every day these butter laden cheese sandwiches made by a mother, which it changes.
Yeah, I know, you know, the party thing, chutney sandwich, homemade chutney sandwich, and I still have that, but not
that's
for
in
the
my
party.
The chutney sandwich is in my book. I still serve that at the party.
Is there something about that homemade, mother made, more delicious than, you know, any
cry when there are 100 kids at your birthday party?
But one of the other things is that sort of thing is, again, also food part of the book. That, you know, it's all about everyone enjoying it together, but writing, whether cooking, eating, consuming, creating. For both of you, you are creators as well as enthusiastic consumers.
Very enthusiastic consumers.
No, but as a family thing, does, you know, all of us have had our palates set. My mothers who were kind and wonderful and just cooked beautiful food.
My mother never cooked. So her mother was cooking for me.
I know,
My daddy was cooking.
Yeah. But I'm saying, hence came the balance.
Yeah.
Is it important to you also that your children are prepared to go out and appreciate the delicious things in life?
Yes, it is very important. I think our kids get very set in what they eat, especially when they are at home. And I've seen it, they're very fussy or they're very stuck on one thing, especially my son will only eat one thing and then for a whole year he will only. So it's important that when we travel with them that we make sure that's when now they've started enjoying different types of cuisine and enjoying different types of food.
Yeah, that's so important actually, just introducing kids to variety and all of us, you know, when you eat variety, you eat, you get nutrients from a whole lot of different kinds of food. And it's not only tasty, but it also gives you a whole range of healthy food. And India is amazing because you have so much variety from all over. And I've been exposed to actually growing up with, you know, Gujarat in Bombay, with Gujarati neighbors, Goan food, Punjabi friend, you know, Farah's food, and then lived abroad. So my book is actually a culmination of, you know, sensibilities. And now I live in Chennai for the last 20 years. So both South India, North India, and, you know, we really have a wonderful celebration of food in our country. So which we need to.
Which Nisha has traveled all over.
I've been exceptionally.
I want to do that kind of show. Because they pay me to travel and eat food everywhere.
I just want to say that you are all my witnesses to this. And I call up Farah tomorrow to say hi, when are we doing this?
No, but then you want to just come to my kitchen and cook them. Take me somewhere.
That will also happen. These are not mutually exclusive things.
But one thing I'd like to add, Anisha, when you talked about the family table, I think the challenge for us new moms,
I'm a very old mother.
Moms in today's world is actually getting the family to sit together at the table. It is really
hard. How many of y'all sit together? Wow, that's more than me. I can't get my family to sit together.
See, that's the challenge which, you know.
But it's almost just 40%.
Yeah.
So 60% of us don't really come together unless it's a Sunday meal or.
And that's one of the things I'm really trying to advocate, is really go back to the family meal, because that's when we sit and we talk to each other, we talk about, you know, whatever's happening, whether it's world events or what you did in your day, and we start to appreciate food, because, you know, my kids would ideally love to go and take their food and eat in front of the TV or even the computer or whatever, but I literally have to make at least one meal a day if we're all home to say, listen, no, you know, food is at the table, because you need to focus on your food, and that becomes conscious eating, because when you're sitting and doing something else, you really don't know how much you're eating, what you're eating. So that's being eroded, that family table that we grew up with. So
everything that you also accomplish. I mean, you know, I remember when just Ochantium was releasing, like there were babies coming, what happened to your babies? You had your babies came, what, 1 month?
No, 3. I was shooting while you were pregnant. My first and second trimester.
There you go. And you've maintained this incredible pace where you're constantly doing.
Actually, I'm not. It looks like I'm constantly doing many things, but I take long gaps between making movies, and I travel at least 3 times a year with my kids. And no mates.
That's lovely.
Yeah. Farah is really, I have to share this, she's an amazing mother. I mean, it's a joy to be with her and her children, because she's really focused on them. I mean, she has a busy life, but when she's with her children and she makes that time, you know, she doesn't, I think, socialize as much as she can. But she really is very, very focused on her kids, and they're absolutely lovely kids with, you know.
Thank you. That's the best compliment I think we all do. We all, that's a two compliment. One, you're looking thinner. And one, your kids are very well behaved.
Just say, like, going forward.
The first one, no one gives me.
I think it's a nice one. I wanted to ask, both the parents have such a wicked sense of humor. Which has the greater influence on them?
I think my kids have now become Thalika Bengal. So, you know, when they are with me, they are like, we're mummy's kids. And then the minute they see their father, they are the father's child. So it's it's both, but my son is definitely more influenced by my husband, I think, because otherwise he's surrounded by girls, you know, and he's seen every chick flick there is to watch.
And you of course are surrounded by
boys. We have three boys. And they're lovely, but they eat, and they eat a lot. They are constantly eating, so she's like constantly cooking. And she's baking her own bread and all sorts of things. I mean, she's just trapping more. I'm like very Sukra children. They're gone with my husband. But her children are constantly eating. So,
That's why my book, first one took so long, because I was trying and testing different kinds of books. And it was, the genesis actually was my son, who was not the youngest, was not eating any fruits and vegetables. And when I used to travel for work, and unlike Farah, I feel a lot of my work travel, I neglected my kids when they were younger. I took them when I could, but you know, as my rural travel involves long trips. So I gave up work travel when I realized my family needed help. And that's when I started to focus on healthy eating and what my kids were eating, and started to cut all the junk and processed food that I was buying them, and started to cook from scratch. And I become so passionate about it because the health of the family improves so tremendously. You know, that was the whole kind of learning for me. My kids had asthma, I had allergies, and all of it kind of gradually went away just from cooking home cooked food. So.
Okay, so guys, listen, I've been a bit greedy, so I think, which is of course true to form and true, I'd like to lead to the theme of this afternoon. But are there any questions?
Does anyone want to ask any questions? Yes?
No, we don't have any. But honey is good for, you know, actually as a cough syrup, even if you have a cough, honey has probably similar effect of cough syrup.
Is there like a special honey for us?
Alright, anyone else who has some food related? No recipes are. Recipe requests are not encouraged at this moment. That's in the book.
Yeah, that's in the book.
A dinner menu at your place might include. I heard from Sharmila.
A dinner menu is very boring actually, no. Because everybody likes to eat the same thing when they come to my house, which is a yakhni pulao, yakhni pulao, but I make it differently because I make mine very little spicy. I'm not so bland. So that, then there's a roast chicken. Then there are very irritating people who come to my house like vegetarians. When the vegetarians come, I give them chips and coupons. And I give it to them and said, please go eat that somewhere. No, but some of the vegetarians, then we make like a Punjabi curry. You know, my cook does that well. Now there's a khatta aloo, which is like a lal mirchi wala aloo, and that's it. That they get these two things. And then we have other things, like we have a lot of fish, like fried fish, bombil. You know bombil, right? Bombay duck and pomfret, and then prawn curry, which we have learned from auntie, and yeah, with kairi in it. But we put kairi and all in it and make it like khatta, like, yeah. Yeah, don't rule your
coin. What about you? You said you deliberately not done a dinner menu, but were you supposed to have other, maybe someone like me over for a dinner? Like, what would be on that
list? When Farah came for dinner, it was her favorites, yeah, with prawn curry and some Goan food, but also homemade breads, and I do a lot of dips and spreads, so like hummus and guacamole and desserts. Farah,
she bakes very well.
So, and my journey actually, because I grew up in a Goan household which was largely meat eating, and with my kids I've actually gone the other way, where my book is literally 90% vegetarian, and we've actually gone, because honestly that's, if you're looking at baby healthy eating, I think vegetarian, largely vegetarian is the way to go. So, we eat mostly vegetarian.
And it's related to all this. Yes, like I said, depending on what the marketing books are for.
I'm sure you have a sensitive
petition. In my case. Yeah.
Oh, that you don't want to go Chennai.
No,
I'm sorry.
No,
we go on
next time.
So, Farah, there's like one by the demand is going on over here. They're asking me to ask you.
Yeah.
So, you had this popular show.
Yeah.
So, when would you like doing it?
Do a food show, like both of us can do one actually, yeah. But yeah, mine is all sorts of recipes. It's like a cooking competition, yeah. But then you're up to my show, they played all sorts of mad games and they have to dance and all that. So actually, I don't know whether it's managed beautifully, but it's managed. It's managed, and I think we all know that women are great multitaskers. You give a man 1.5 things to do, he's not going to do the one thing. You can give a woman 8 things to do, and they all will be done to a certain degree of. No, thank you, Lala. All actually, I think most women manage. Not most, I would say all of them manage. Especially working at, I think the working woman who goes 9 to 5 and has to go every day to work, you know, and still come back home, make that meal, cut the vegetables in the train, come back to make the meal in the morning for the kids. The tiffin, I mean, hats off to that. We still have got like staff and we've got help and. So we can't be impacting ourselves too much. But I would say that time management is something that comes very easily, and I'm a very organized to a OCD level. I'm very organized. So if I'm making a movie, in the morning the cook will get a call as to what to cook at home, and in the middle of shooting also everything is. In fact, sharp 6 o'clock my cook will call me. It's the most irritating question of all time. Started now with the kids mixing the atta and slowly weaning them off. things like that.
To me, I grew up with a sweet tooth because my mom cooked cakes and puddings and desserts all the time. It's the, I mean, the hardest habit to cook, you know, sugar. And to me, the first thing I do at home to kind of get us to eat healthy is to cut the sugar. Because since I had a sweet tooth, I happily fed my children something sweet after every meal. And now it's really, really hard. So actually I put a teaspoon, an actual teaspoon measure in my sugar jar, and we literally cut sugar wherever we can. So I think that's the first thing for me. Besides, of course, eating, you know, switching oils, eating actually cold processed oils, refined oils are bad, whole grains, and lots of fruits and vegetables. I think that's the biggest thing you can do, just add lots of fruits and vegetables to your diet. Whether you like it or not, whether you like it or not, but that's one of the key messages.
That's it. Thank you so much. On behalf of the entire club, I would like to ask Farah, when are we meeting Shah Rukh Khan? And
I knew I was called here for some other reason. This God told me of course. Definitely, I think we'll keep one specially for the poetry ladies. Yeah. Yeah. We'll organize something. Yes. Shah Rukh Khan will come specially for you, Tanjina. Certainly.
Yeah.
We'll love it.
For us, Shah Rukh Khan for on Valentine's Day.
Not only want Charlotte, she wants a very specific day. And if anything he has to get for you, and now.
कट करो बस कट करो।
ये जो किताब है ये मेरी स्कूल फ्रेंड है शर्मिला रिबेरियो और उसने ये बहुत अच्छी कुक बुक लिखी है विच इज सो हेल्दी ईटिंग एंड हेल्दी कुकिंग। ये आपकी पूरी फैमिली स्पेशली बच्चों को जो आइडिया हम डाल सकते हैं कि अभी से हेल्दी उनको कैसे खिलाएं हम हेल्दी ईटिंग एवरीडे लव जो रोज़ का प्यार है वो खाने में डालें और अपने बच्चों को अपनी पूरी फैमिली को हेल्दी कुकिंग की तरफ लेकर जाएं।
शर्मिला जी आप क्या कहना चाहेंगी?
हाँ माय मैसेज इज बेसिकली ईट कुक फॉर योर किड्स विद लव यू नो मेक श्योर योर किड्स अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट हेल्दी ईटिंग फ्रॉम द यंग एज से नो टू जंक एंड प्रोसेस फूड एंड टीच योर बॉयज टू कुक नॉट ओनली योर गर्ल्स बट टीच द बॉयज टू कुक So from a young age, they know out and they can be better husbands when they grow up. So.
Okay, पर आपसे मेरा सवाल है कि मतलब कितना मैथी पोषण वाला है क्या लोग पढ़ने वाले हैं इसको पढ़ने के बाद?
ये अभी बुक को पढ़ने के बाद कितना सीखने वाले हैं मुझे नहीं पता लेकिन अगर आप ये बुक के रेसिपीज फॉलो करेंगे तो डेफिनेटली यू विल सी दैट आपके हेल्थ में आपके बहुत बदलाव आएगा क्योंकि जो हर चीज़ जो रेसिपी है एक हेल्दी ऑल्टरनेटिव रेसिपी टू जंक फूड रेसिपी इसमें है। आज मैं तो फॉलो कर रही हूँ ये 5 साल से मेरे को रेसिपीज भेज रही है और मैं ट्राई करती हूँ घर पर बनाती हूँ बच्चों को भी खिलाती हूँ मेरी डॉटर भी अभी इसमें से खुद कुकिंग करती है तो ये सारी रेसिपीज शर्मिला ने मुझ पर ट्राई एंड टेस्टेड किया है। आई एम रेकमेंडिंग दिस बुक टू एवरीबडी नॉट ओनली बॉलीवुड। Okay.
So, food blogging, there are a lot of advice and a lot of junk food. So, how do you recommend to increase the level of junk food or maintain mindset or something like that?
Yeah. You have to actually, the junk food is really unhealthy. It's basically salt, sugar, maida, oil. You know, those are the definitions of junk food, food that's high and all of that. So first, ideally you should cook yourself. But if you can't cook from there,
it's difficult to do that.
So you just be conscious of what you're eating, you know. So if you're buying a ready-made food, you read the labels. You see how much sugar, fat, and sodium, and you know, preservatives there in the food. So that's one step. Just being conscious of what you're eating, and increase the amount of fruits and vegetables you can eat, which you can eat also raw. You know, fruits and vegetables and things you can eat raw. You don't have to cook.
I think. So, once in a way, everybody eats junk food. हम भी खाते हैं और once in a way, it's all right also. But every day खाएंगे तो obviously serious health issues होंगे. तो जितना आप health और अभी healthy options सब जगह मिलते हैं. अगर आप खुद भी नहीं पका सकते हैं, तो healthy option आपको हर जगह मिलते हैं. या मेरी तरफ से सिंपल यही है. मैं कब से बोल रही हूँ कि बहुत सारी चीज़ें आप चेंज कर सकते हैं कि आप जैसे मैंने एरेटेड वाटर बंद कर दिया है पूरा. मैं बहुत पहले बहुत सारे एरेटेड कोलाज एंड सोडाज हर मील के साथ यू हैव जस्ट कट इट ऑफ नो हैव नींबू पानी इंस्टेड विदाउट शुगर और जस्ट
कोकोनट वाटर
इट्स ईजी टू डू दैट जो आपको भी नहीं लगे कि मैं नहीं पी रही हूँ. एंड एक्चुअली जो ज़ीरो और डाइट कोला से वो तो और भी ख़राब है क्योंकि उसमें एस्पर्टामिन होता है. तो आई थिंक दैट इज़ इवन मोर डेंजरस. तो दैट डेफिनेटली दैट हैज कट आउट. यू कैन कट आउट रिफाइंड शुगर छोटा छोटा चीज़
फर्स्ट
करो बिकॉज आप पूरा करने जाओगे तो मुझसे भी नहीं होता है. तो जैसे अब मैं गेहूँ का आटा नहीं खाती हूँ. मैं बाजरे की रोटी या ज्वार की रोटी उसका आटे का बनाकर चपाती खाती हूँ. तो सिंपल लाइक दैट. थोड़ा अभी घी जैसे मैंने कहा घी बैक इन फैशन है. घी ऑर्गेनिक घी इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी हेल्दी.
इट्स अ गुड
फैट. सो ट्राई टू पुट लिटिल घी इन योर फूड रादर देन सम स्ट्रेंज ऑयली व्हिच इज.
कैन यू थ्रो सम लाइट ऑन कीटो डाइट एंड वेगन डाइट एंड आर दे पार्ट ऑफ द रेसिपीज.
आई डोंट थिंक सो. नो
सी वी आर नॉट रेकमेंडिंग एनी डाइट. ये हम हेल्दी फूड
हम कोई डाइट वेट लॉस के लिए ये बुक नहीं है. ये अपनी हेल्थ के लिए बुक है कि तो मैं कभी भी कोई क्रैश डाइट ऐसी कीटो के कार्ब्स ही बंद कर दो तो मेरा भेजा ही नहीं चलेगा. क्योंकि कार्बोहाइड्रेट इज़ ब्रेन फूड इज़ रिक्वायर्ड यू नो फॉर एवरीथिंग इज़ रिक्वायर्ड इन अ करेक्ट पोर्शन. एक्चुअली ऑर्गेनिक इज वेरी गुड टू गो इफ यू कैन अफोर्ड इट. आई अग्री दैट ऑर्गेनिक फूड काफ़ी महंगे होते हैं.
Yeah, because I really believe that the kind of cooking we do as mothers and parents every day for our kids is an act of love. And if we make it healthy and we are conscious about what we are feeding our children and our families, it is really truly
everyday
love.
आपकी मम्मी भी पहले टिफिन बांधती होगी आपका. तो हाँ अभी कौन अभी भी मम्मी बांधती है ना.
If you cook for your families real good healthy food rather than buying them some junk food, that is love.
और ये आप लोग भी सीख सकते हैं इससे. मर्द जो हैं जो अकेले रहते हैं कभी आजकल तो सारे I think most men cook. Because they are living alone.
This is a book that is both very easy to cook from. It's attractive. Kids are cooking from it.
और ये main चीज़ है ये सारे ingredients India में बहुत Indian ingredients हैं. ऐसे कभी कभी मैं cookbook लेती हूँ pomelo salads और ये कहाँ से ढूँढूँ समझ में नहीं आता. तो ये सारे ingredients आपको आपके local market में मिल जाएंगे.
और इसमें पूरा एक section है homemade fast food. So you can
हाँ करेक्ट मैं ही करती हूँ कुक. मैंने एक पूरा शो बनाया था यार कुकिंग पे. अगर मेरे को फूड बेस्ड फिल्म देखना बहुत पसंद है. ओके जिसमें दिखाते हैं खाना और इट्स आई लव दोज मूवीज वेर यू शो गुड फूड एंड गुड कुकिंग एंड ब्यूटिफुली शॉट. तो कभी डेफिनेटली ट्राई करूँगी. लेकिन प्रॉब्लम होगी ना फिर मैं वो फिल्म में बहुत मोटी हो जाऊँगी. वो फिल्म बनाते ओके थैंक यू. क्या बात है यार कोई कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल क्वेश्चन नहीं. हाँ और एक्चुअली वी वांट टू आल्सो थैंक द रोटरी विमेन्स क्लब ऑफ मुंबई बिकॉज दे हैव ऑर्गेनाइज एलिगेंट
रोटरी क्लब ऑफ मुंबई
एलिगेंट रोटरी क्लब ऑफ मुंबई एलिगेंट जिन्होंने ये बहुत अच्छा सेशन रखा आज इंटरैक्टिव सेशन टू फाइंड आउट. थैंक यू तहमीना. थैंक यू अनिता.
Done.